been here for like 10 minutes.
The kind of guy you'd see standing in line at the dry cleaners or the grocery store. Never stick out of the crowd. Clean cut guy.
I'm under arrest?
No, I want to talk to you. Go ahead, have a seat.
I knew it. Go ahead and trust me.
You knew what? No, just sit tight. And what are you doing here?
On a clear day, rise and look around you, and you will see who you are.
Beth, you are a real cutie. How are you doing?
Ah, thank you. I'm fine.
So the first thing that demands our attention is the screen name Kinky Man in Corona. Obviously, Babst lived in the town of Corona, so it wasn't even like Corona was his favorite beer or anything. That was just the town where he lived. But the fact that he would put Kinky Man in Corona clearly indicates that he used this screen name for sexual purposes. So Babst was married, and in his interview with Chris, he claims that he had never been with anyone except his wife. But he's using this screen name, which is, I mean, dude, the screen name that you have doesn't jive with the fucking real life. I guess that's common online, but that's certainly, he was living out fantasies through the internet. That's what his screen name, that's what we can deduce from that kind of screen name. And then, of course, this generic decoy name, Bubble Beth 2005. That's 110% a typical decoy name that they would use. Cool.
Smiley face, what's your ASL? You there? Lol, okay, bye.
She's like, dude, I don't have time for your shit. Sorry, Beth, I got booted off. Are you still there? You know, and not having time for it, so the decoy also articulates that Babst links the decoy who is chatting with him now to another decoy who was trying to get predators to show up at the same sting, which I guess I never really thought about it before, but it makes sense that they would have like four or five or who knows how many different decoys, like all in the same area, like all representing these different these different personas and trying to get different guys. It just makes sense that they would have like six or however many decoys they have working together kind of just in different locations throughout. To increase the chances, although I don't really think they even needed to increase the chances, unfortunately.
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, excellent spelling of here, so we're gonna be playing that game. Alright. Cool. You are really a cutie. No school this week? See, he knows, so he must have been looking on some kind of thing that showed the decoy's age and that clearly indicated that she was a minor. So this goes to speak that he had full awareness that the decoy was a minor, and that what he was soliciting and what he was suggesting was criminal.
Not it. Not till next time. Not till next.
Cool. I take it parents aren't home.
Mom's at work.
That's one of the best fucking decoy lines that there is. That just screams decoy in every... That's like literally the kind of try-hard thing that Dan Allen was suggesting. Like the purposeful misspelling of words. Yeah. Lol. Don't think she would like you being in an adult chat?
Eh, it's just Cali room.
Okay, so he is already... immediately gonna take it to this sexual element, and he's already like raising the question of like, oh, so is anyone there? Like, is there any chance that a person who's a parent or a teacher or something, are they gonna look over your shoulder and fucking catch me up? He was already looking out for trying to cover his own ass at this point. Yes, but have to go into an adult area to get there? It's cool. I don't care. Lol. Just telling you, mom might not like it. Dude, what are you talking about? You have to get into an adult area. I mean, maybe the chat room is like 18 and up and the decoy just like bullshitted the age, but either way, I don't understand what the hell he meant by it. You have to go into an adult area. I mean, dude, you're just clicking a tab, so I don't understand what the hell he was talking about.
Eh, I don't care. She don't know. She's leaving this weekend anyway.
Damn, she's not wasting any time. She's like letting him know. She's letting him know about the business that's going to be happening. Oh, okay. That's cool. So you are independent and here very cool. lol, just watch out for guys like me. Dude, that's so fucking dark. The fact that he jokes about it, that just goes to show how fucking detached and how disassociated he is from reality. He must spend so much time just on the internet, like with porn shit, that he completely disconnects. Like the Jeff Stacy, the real life and internet are two different things. Babs in this moment would have trouble making that, obviously he would have trouble making that distinction. It's like he's acting in a way that is so inconsistent with how he spends his professional life, and he knows it, and he's almost taking some kind of glee in it, which is especially disturbing. And human beings, for whatever twisted reason, just tend to take pleasure in that.
Smiley face.
Oh, I am a nice guy, but I really think you are cute. Dude, I don't think you understand what that word means. And not just in that innocent, oh, isn't she a cute girl way, lol. And that's very disturbing that he would say that and then fucking laugh about it.
Oh, for reals?
Yes.
What's your ASL?
Oh shit, he's honest. 40, male, in Corona. I know, you're like 40. Lol, way old, I know. Oh, he's just speaking for her. He's trying to quote her. He should have put some quotations there. Oh, I know, you're like 40.
Lol, nah, 70 is old. You're not old.
And that is a very interesting spelling of is right there. Fuck, that's an uncommon decoy spelling. Cool.
Smiley face.
Is profile pic your only pic?
Nah, I got one more.
May I see it? Thanks. Very nice.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's the fucking bullshit. The decoy used a pretty ridiculous picture. The fact that he would still click on this, that just goes to show how fucking twisted Babst was in his mind. I bet you look great in skirts too, don't you?
I look aight.
I love the fucking aight.
I look aight.
Lol. Well, I love a girl in skirts.
Cool. Smiley face.
Do you get to shop for yourself yet?
Every once in a while, my mom doesn't let me go a whole lot of places by myself.
She doesn't let you go a whole lot of places by yourself. See, and that's probably just the decoy, like laying out fucking traps, like laying out breadcrumbs and seeing if the predator is gonna fucking walk into the trap that the decoy is clearly setting for him there. Yeah. I can understand that, but you have, that's cool. I am curious, what's up with all the fucking ellipses? I think that's what it's called, the fucking, the dot dot dots, dude. I don't know, that's a little excessive right here. I mean, I'm doing a hyperbolic kind of impersonation of Babs, but like the way that he's fucking chatting, actually kind of, he'd be speaking like this, you know, in whispers and shit. Yeah, I can understand that, but you have, that's cool. I am curious. Do you get to pick what you want for clothes? Okay, so he's gonna just go fucking thong, or he's gonna start taking in that direction.
Sometimes, if mom's likes it. Sometimes she says no.
Dude, that's not just a one-time spelling. The decoy is gonna be committed to spelling fucking words like sometimes just like that. That's fucking excellent. Lol, figures. Lol, bet she says no to all the hot stuff. Yeah, dude, of course she would, because she would hopefully be a good parent, you fucking asshole.
Yeah, she's a drag.
Lol, same. Goes for panties too, right?
Yeah.
You want thongs and G-strings? Dude, that's so ridiculous that he would say this to someone who's this age. Babs is a fucking, a true scumbag.
Yeah, they're cool. Lots of girls at my school wear them.
I know, lol. Well, you could always buy a couple pair and keep them secret.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, maybe when mom leaves.
Where is she going? Will you just be... will just be you and dad then, or who?
She's going to RC.
Oh, she's going to Oregon or something?
She's going to Oregon to see some friends. And nah, my dad's split.
Okay, so we're getting the broken wing decoy game, the broken parent, the broken family dynamic. So the predator feels more at ease. This is extremely common. And it puts having the father out of the picture, that would immediately assuage a lot of Babs' anxiety because, I mean, in America, it's like that's the one who's probably going to kill you. It's going to be the fucking dad. So these guys are kind of hyper aware, or at least if they have any common sense at all, like a basic fear response, that's what they'd be afraid of. And that's why a lot of them think that Hansen's a dad. So, who will you be with?
Just me, thank God. We'll have to listen to bitchin'.
And that's a really weird way to say it. That almost looks like you're saying like a Bitcoin or something. Wow, for how long?
Mom's leaving today like noon and coming back Sunday night. She lent me money for pizza and stuff. It's gonna be cool.
Dude, this is like the only thing she's missing is like the word fucking like radical. This is a joke. This is some Disney movie bullshit that she's saying, but that Babst is actually believing. And that's it just goes to show that Babst is completely, truly out of his mind at this point.
Oh, wow. Cool. Yeah, lol, want some company, lol, damn.
So he immediately suggested them meeting up, and she didn't even directly bring it up. She only told him that she was going to basically have the house to herself. So he not only initiated the chat, he's the one who's bringing up and initiating actually meeting together in real life. The fact that he denies as vehemently as he did in his interaction with Chris what he was going to do is bullshit when you actually fucking read the chat log. And the chat log truly does not lie.
You want to come over?
And she hits him with that immediately. See, this is a good decoy. This decoy is not playing any games. She's not even trying to fucking, she's not trying to waste her time on any guys who are just going to bullshit.
Yep.
Smiley face.
Honest?
What is honest? Like, you know, what are you asking?
Nah, I'm asking why you want to come over.
Yes, I do want to come over. Why? Would love to get you naked.
So he is immediately jumping into the sex talk. We're only a few fucking pages into this and he's not going to waste any time.
For reals? I've never done that before.
Dude, how fucking dark. You know, lines like that they're extremely disturbing when you recall and put it into its proper context of what was actually going down. It really makes you hate this guy. Lol. Well, would do more than that.
Like what?
Oh, this is one of the things that they read for the To Catch a Predator show. Man, the guy who read this chat log sounded so unenthusiastic. It's fucking hilarious. He's like, well, I would get naked too, and we would have sex.
So I do want to come over. Why? Would love to get you naked.
For reals? I've never done that before.
Well, would do more than that.
Like what?
Well, I would get naked too, and we would have sex.
He just says it in a way that's like completely casual. You can imagine him like shrugging his shoulders and shit when he was saying it.
Wow, do you want to do that with me?
Yup.
I don't know. I've never done anything like that. I might not be any good at it.
Yeah, he doesn't give a shit.
I'm sure you would be awesome. You have to learn. Yes. But I know I would totally enjoy it.
Yeah, no shit, dude. That's fucking obvious. And it's especially dark that he would use the word learn, especially given that he's a fucking teacher. So once again, this is just like him taking glee in the fact that he's doing something that is so taboo, especially given his position as an educator.
Yes.
Tear face.
Yeah. Have you had period yet? Jesus Christ, dude. That's so fucked to even ask. This is fucking sickening.
Yeah, started last year.
Oh, and then a frown face, Jesus Christ.
Why?
I cum a lot, and it's potent.
Dude, yeah, right. I doubt that your cum is potent. I think your cum is of average potency, man. And even if you had a few kids, that wouldn't even matter. There's no way that your cum is as potent. What a stupid-ass flex, too, to try and fucking pump himself up.
Oh, that could, like, make me preggers, right? She's all, that's how it works, right? It's not dystoric, is it?
Yes.
Oh.
Would prefer not to use condom and pull out, but risky, because you are so hot. I am not sure I would be able to get it without shooting some in you. Yeah, he is completely enjoying this. This dude's mind is it's on a completely different level.
Aw, you think I'm hot? No, I has never said that.
Yes.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Do you got a job?
Yes.
What you do?
Teacher.
Ooh, for real? Not my school, is it?
Yeah, see, so the decoy at that point, the actual decoy must have been like, no fucking way. Like, you know, is this guy actually a teacher? That would be anyone's response. And then a smiley face. That must have been a grudging smiley face to actually fucking type.
Where do you go to school?
Nope. Where do you go to school?
Mira Loma.
What city is that in?
It's in Mira Loma. Dude, she's like, it is where it is. What the fuck are you talking about?
Lol, okay. Like right by Corona, I think? Dude, that's crazy that this is Corona. Jeez, man.
Oh.
Yeah, I think it would be cool if I had a teacher. I think it would be cool if I had you for a teacher because you're cool.
No, I think it's very unfortunate that this guy was ever a teacher. I mean, of course, the decoy is going to say that, but I wonder what his response to that is. Jeez.
Lol, if you were at my school, I couldn't come over. I never do anything with students like that. What are you talking about?
So the only reason that he wouldn't do it is because it's kind of like the don't shit where you eat, like that old saying. He's just worried about literally getting caught, and that's it. That's the only barrier in his mind that would prevent him from doing this. So if he had the opportunity to get away with it, who knows? And, you know, he might have, being a teacher, he might have had plenty of opportunities. It's a very disturbing thought, but you just don't fucking know.
What is your address?
I can't tell you right now, silly. Lol, I just met you.
Even though you're volunteering all this fucking bullshit to this guy? That's funny. That's slightly inconsistent, but Babs isn't going to be, he's not going to be on that level of awareness. He's just lost in fantasy.
I know, but you want me to come up, but if you want me to come over, I need to know it.
Well, in a little while, my mom's not even gone yet. She saw, dude, cool your jets. He's not even, we're not even fucking there yet. Like shit is not even set in stone, dude. I can call you if you want.
Maybe. Do you have a mic on your computer?
Nah, moms won't let me have a mic or a cam because she says I'll get in trouble with it.
Yeah, that's a good, you'd have to make some kind of excuse for that. You wouldn't be able to just admit, you know, you wouldn't be able to just be like, yeah, dude, I'm a decoy. You know, here's what I look like. You'd have to give some kind of response that, you know, you couldn't have one because it was forbidden in your house or that you didn't have the actual webcam. But that's a good excuse, and of course Babs is going to buy it because it's plausible.
Yep, you would, lol.
Lol, who, me?
Wow, that's the level that she's at.
Who, me? Smiley face, all BRB, got to pee.
And there we go with the pee bit. That's another fucking trail. She's just going to see if he's going to take a few steps on that trail that she showed him exists, you know, to see when the decoy, and they do this often. They say, oh, I'm going to go pee, you know, and they do that one just to fucking, it's bait and they're seeing who's going to take it.
Hold on.
I'm back.
Okay.
What's up?
Not much.
Dude, this guy and his fucking, the ellipsis, I mean, he just hits him so fucking hard.
I'm actually hard.
I didn't read that. So when I said he hits these hard, I think that was just a fucking cosmic coincidence.
Not much. I'm actually hard thinking about you.
Oh, for reals?
Yes.
That's cool. Why are you hard?
I don't know if the decoy is going to feign ignorance about male anatomy, but it's funny that that she actually says that.
Thinking about having sex with you.
Smiley face, I'm blushing.
Yeah, the decoy's probably so annoyed in real life, I know I would be.
What are you wearing at the moment?
My boxers and tank I sleep in. I look kind of messy, ain't brushed my hair.
Yeah, panties or under the boxers?
Yeah.
What are they like?
They're pink with puffy Amy Yummy on them.
I don't know what the hell puffy Amy Yummy is.
Lol, not sure who that is, but okay.
It's a cartoon.
Okay, so I guess, yeah, we both fucking learned something. We're all learning something here.
Okay.
I like them. They're cute.
Lol, cool. I would like you out of them.
Hee hee.
No, I mean it. I mean it. Take them off. Lol.
Lol, but it's cold in here.
She's, I don't know if this is the cool thing. That's the second one. Spelling cold with a K is like another fucking curveball. That's a fucking spelling curveball right there.
Put boxers back on.
Is that what you want me to wear if you come over?
Look at that, we have another if you come over.
No.
Oh, what you want me to wear?
A skirt. You are shortest in top.
Cool, I got a plaid one, is that okay?
Perfect. Are you by Sacramento?
Nah, I'm in Mira Loma.
Dude, this is like the third fucking time she's told him.
It's in Riverside.
Okay.
Hey, you drink?
Yes.
Have you ever had Mike's Lemonade?
That stuff's good. Oh, Mike's Lemonade fucking hates that their association with this show is so strong. And it makes so much sense that the decoy would suggest that he brings over fucking lemonade.
Yeah.
Well, my mom's ain't got none here, and I was wanting to party a little. You could bring me some.
Oh, bringing Mike's Lemonade was such a fucking... It was so... And, you know, the guy, Alonzo Wade, who brought, like, Bush Beer and Mike's Hard Lemonade, and who then said he was going to drink both of them, it's like, no, dude, bullshit. You would never drink Mike's Hard Lemonade and beer. Like, unless you were hard up. But I think 9 times out of 10, it's going to be either or for the night, you know. If you're going hard on either or, it would be like, you got to stick to the whatever one you choose would be the safest way to go about it.
If you're coming over.
Yes, I could. Tell me, would you want me to get condoms?
I really don't want to get preggers. You maybe should.
Well, your choice, condom, or I pull out.
Condoms, just in case?
Your call. Feels better bare, but I understand.
Dude, I don't know. It's like, even in this age, it would be so easy for a DNA test to prove that he was the father. So... whether he would actually show up and have unprotected sex with a decoy, I guess we'll never know. But he's just completely out of it. He's not making... His mind is just in such a dark, twisted place that he's 100% separated from reality.
Bring him, and if it would feel better, we can use him or not.
She's all, dude, it doesn't matter. Just show up, as long as you show up.
Okay. When was last period?
3 weeks.
3 weeks? So you are due to start soon.
Might be.
What's he gonna like try and fucking just use the time? That's not gonna be an effective way to prevent pregnancy, dude.
Oh. Not regular?
Sometimes it's weird.
See, and for you to even say that, like, the character that the decoy is playing is a 12-year-old, I think saying, oh, not regular, like, there's such a slim chance that a 12-year-old, or maybe they would, I don't fucking know, but it seems like something that would be above a 12-year-old's head.
Sometimes it's weird.
But should be.
It will stop soon, or go for too long.
Yeah. Should go on pill or depot shot. Dude, what are you talking about? We'll stabilize it or eliminate it altogether.
Yeah, I probably will one day.
Yeah, a day long in the future. Long in the fucking future.
But at 3 weeks, you are pretty safe.
Yeah, just not totally sure.
That's cool. Do you have any hair? Ugh.
On my kitty?
Yes.
Not really. Yet.
That's so disturbing, dude. Cool. And then he responds fucking cool. So you say you have a plaid skirt?
Yep. It's so cute.
How short?
Like half to the knee. Halfway.
That's okay. And what top do you have to go with it?
I usually wear a white shirt with it. Like button up.
Does it get tucked in or is it short enough that it doesn't? Dude, are you just like going off on this schoolgirl fantasy? I think that's where he's going with it.
Short enough.
And shoes?
I usually wear black and white shoes with it.
Nice. Knee highs?
Sometimes pantyhose, sometimes knee socks.
And the decoy is totally bullshitting. Yeah, he's just flickering through all these images that he's having in his fucking mind.
So Babs is probably a person with a vivid imagination as well. You know, he's one of these people who could live online and experience a great amount of enjoyment from just indulging in these psychological fantasies that he has, or that he has often.
No, I don't like pantyhose.
Okay, you want me to wear socks?
Yes. He's like, fucking don't wear those. Maybe someone in his like life wore them when he was younger or something, and he doesn't like them for that reason.
Yes.
Cool.
So that's the list of what you wear? That's it, totally?
Yeah, I guess you want me to wear something else?
No, that will work. She's
all, dude, is that not good enough for you?
No, that will work nicely. But nothing more than exactly what is on the list.
Jeez, dude. A little controlling already. Immediately in.
Oh, okay.
Nothing more. Yeah, he reiterates.
I know.
So no panties or bra.
Okay. If that's what you like.
So she's already past the point of even like playing hard to get. She's kind of just going to start going along. Yeah, she's going to start going along with all this bullshit, given like the, oh yeah, sure, the nods, like, oh yeah, yeah, definitely.
Okay, if that's what you like.
I love it.
Smiley face, will you add me on your list? Cool.
Do you have a cell?
Nah, mom says I'm too young. Told you, she's a drag.
Yeah.
I can call you where she won't hear.
Yeah?
Yeah, I can get the phone from downstairs and call and she won't hear the phone ring.
What's your number?
I meant call you. She checks the call ID. If you call, she'll hear it. And want to know who it is.
So she's just coming up with a bunch of excuses.
Oh, okay. Well, it's risky to have you call here.
Why?
You there?
Yeah, I'm here. So, dude, I haven't left.
Do you see my pic in the chat window?
Yeah.
Think you will like that in you? Oh, that's one of the lines that Chris gives him when he's having his fucking nervous breakdown.
How big is it?
And here, so, well, you saw. Go get a can of Coke.
So this guy's using a fucking Coke can to reference his own dick. Once more, we have a lot of negative publicity that I'm sure Coca-Cola would not fucking appreciate.
Dang.
Dang, will it hurt?
A little, yes, at first.
Oh, be gentle, right? Oh, you'll be gentle, right?
Yes, I want you to enjoy it.
That's cool.
I would love to hear you.
I want to hear you too, but I have to call you because I could get in so much trouble.
Yeah, me too.
Your mom's?
Lol, no.
Why you get in trouble?
Married and a teacher.
Oh, okay. Do you have a celly?
No.
Because you could go somewhere with it where people can't hear.
Oh, no one home now.
Lol, then why are you scared? I won't call unless you say it's okay.
Cause you would do the same for me.
Yeah.
I really wish you would call me, but Mom's is here and still nosy.
Yeah, I understand. When is she leaving?
I think noon, but let me go ask for sure.
Okay.
What time did you maybe want to come over?
After she leaves. Yeah, no shit, dude. What are you just gonna fucking greet the mom as she's walking out? Like, hey, what's up?
Like, right after?
Probably, and or tomorrow.
Kay.
Kay, let me ask.
Okay.
Okay, I got it backwards. She's leaving tonight and coming back Sunday afternoon. So you can come tonight after about 9 or 9:30.
So Bab showed up pretty shortly after the chat begun, I think in like 2 days or something, from what I read on the Perverted Justice website. So yeah, the decoys oftentimes would like have to just schedule like when the people were going to show up. So they'd have to fucking like bracket them in and like make a specific time and then like pencil them in for like 7 p.m. on Friday and like 3 p.m. on Saturday.
So you can come tonight after about 9 or 9:30.
No, tomorrow.
What time tomorrow?
Not sure.
I mean day or night. So I know when to wake up and take a bath and get ready.
Day.
Oh, how about like 1 so I don't have to wake up all early?
Damn, so the decoy's gonna sleep in like all day? This 12-year-old's gonna fucking wake up at 1 p.m.?
Maybe a little earlier, so I have more time.
Okay. Like 11?
Yeah. Around then.
That would work. I just can't stay up late tonight. Smiley face.
Okay. Ready. Oh my god. Ready to lose your virginity?
I think so. I'm a little scared, but you'll be nice, right?
Of course. Play and kiss and lick you and get you really excited.
All the girls in my school have done stuff with guys, and I haven't, so I think I want to.
Regardless of what the minor would say, it doesn't matter because they're not even capable of the consent in the first place.
Cool.
Smiley face.
And you'll bring the mics too?
And you'll bring the mics too?
Lol, yes. The mics. The mics lemonade. The infamous mics.
I would love you forever. I'd love you forever if you would bring it. I love it.
Jeez.
I would love you forever if you bring it. I love it.
Okay, I will. I will stop and get them.
Yay!
That will be easy to get. Shouldn't need anything else.
Nah, that'll be cool. She's all, dude, the mics is good enough.
Good. Then just the mics.
Yeah.
Great. Glad you agree.
Can't wait for tomorrow.
Me either. You will get to watch as the bare head parts your pussy lips. It's so hot.
Sounds so cool.
Yes, and you can see your wetness on the skin of my cock. It's awesome.
So Babs is college educated, and he's obviously taking a few fucking writing classes because he's like conducting his own little erotic literature over here already. The decoy's like giving this extremely poor grammar, and he's actually trying to fucking write like a literotica entry, like with each line on this shit.
Wow, I just hope I'll be good enough.
You will be, I know. And wait till you see the whole bear cock disappear.
See, this is like the second time he said bear cock, so the second time he said bear, so he's like repeating these words to like add extra emphasis on the bear part. He is ridiculous.
Be my first time to see that. Smiley face.
And feel it. So good skin to skin.
Oh, that's why you didn't want the condoms. Smiley face.
Yes, not even going to get any.
Okay, that's cool, but just don't get me preggers. That would be
not good.
That would so not be good.
Yeah, that's quite a fucking understatement right there about that situation not being good. And that's extremely dark, you know, for people who work in hospitals or whatnot and who actually have to see that. That's, they may not be in law enforcement, but man, some people who work in hospitals see some shit that is like right up there with, you know, things that are illegal and things that cops would actually have to deal with too.
I know. I will pull out and shoot my cum all over your belly and pussy lips.
Oh, cause that's good. Is she asking or saying there? Oh, cause that's good, smiley face.
Want you to taste it too.
How does it taste?
Lol, I taste mine all the time. Kinda reminds me of uncooked pancake batter. Not great, but not terrible. Dude, you taste it all the time. And then you say it tastes like pancake batter? Jeez.
Oh. Oh, okay. Oh, okay, not really. Like anything than that, right?
Yeah, I guess. I am not crazy about taste, but I love licking it out of a girl's pussy when I come in here.
Dude, that's very vivid and very fucking disturbing when you say it like that.
Wow, you want to do that with me?
When I can come in you, yes.
Oh, so here's the indicating that, you know, he's going to stay. I mean, of course, I think that this is all just bullshit. You know, what is he trying to communicate here? Is he trying to communicate that he's going to stick around? I wonder if the decoy is going to pick up and kind of take him up on that.
Oh.
You know, take him up on that inquiry, basically.
Oh.
But we'll lick it off of you tomorrow.
Mmm, yum, yum.
And share it with you.
Okay, I ain't tried it before, but now I can.
Yes, you can.
Your name is showing up as John, is that you?
Yes.
Cool, I'm Beth.
No, you're not John, dude. You're fucking Walter Babst. You're Walter Babst, also known as Walter White, for your fucking ridiculous mustache and knowledge about mathematics and presumably chemistry.
Cool, I'm Beth.
Hi, Beth.
My mom's telling me I gotta be cleaning my room before she goes tonight. If you want me to call you, I can do that at the same time. But if not, then I gotta go. She's all, dude, I can either call you or fucking, like, I'm out. Like, I got shit to do.
I would like that.
Okay, what's your number?
Lol, yours first. Oh, you're gonna play the coy game, dude? Really? You're the fucking 40-year-old dude and you're gonna play that bullshit?
I can't give you mine. Moms will hear you if you call me.
Yeah, damn right. The decoy's like, dude, I don't want to fucking give you my phone number. No, he's gonna need to give his. And so she could call from the fucking blocked. Whoever gives out their actual number in this exchange, they would certainly be called with a blocked number. Or they would probably be called with a fucking blocked number.
I can't give you mine. Moms will hear it.
You said
you're alone.
Damn, so she's using argumentation. She's like, dude, you know, given our two situations, it makes sense for you to do it, and it'd be easier for you to do it. So she's trying to persuade him.
I am.
You won't. So you won't get in trouble, but I will.
To be honest, don't like to give out number. But you have caller ID, don't you?
Yep.
So do I.
Yeah, but you can probably delete numbers, so I can't, because my mom's got a lock on it. Because she's so damn nosy.
Right, but want to know if you are calling.
Dude, this is like a fucking standoff where neither person wants to divulge their own number, and both of them are kind of just like trying to get the other person to basically trust. You know, this is about self-disclosing your actual number, and neither party here wants to fucking do that. Reasonably.
Right, but want to know if you are calling.
I'll only call when you say. I don't want you to get in trouble.
I appreciate that.
Wait, what's that?
Let's me get your info for my email.
What? So he must have sent some kind of alternate like link or something to the decoy that we don't have access to.
Dumb thing. WTF. It's not working. Wait, do it again. Did you get it?
Yes.
KK.
You can do the same.
How you do it?
Under actions, request contact details.
Oh, so they're just requesting contact details. So this is just going to give him the contact info that's linked to the account. Is that what it means? Because his account is Kinky Man and Corona, which is probably like a fucking secret account. I doubt that that's the account that he's using with his wife, especially when he gives his, oh, I've only ever been with my wife. Like, he's trying to say, like, I'm too prim and prop. That argument is basically, you know, I've never done anything like this. Like, you know, I don't do this. So for him to have a name like Kinky Man and Corona, he would need to hide that from his wife, based off of the interaction that he had with Chris. And based off of the assumptions that we can make and infer about the relationship that he had, his marriage with his wife.
KK, what's your area? What's your area code? 909?
No.
951?
Lol, could be. Okay, dude, why are you playing coy when you're the one talking about meeting up and doing all this bullshit, and then you're fucking pussying out at the last minute, man?
Well, your number's in here, but I ain't got no AC. If you don't want me to call, I won't.
I know. I do, but right now?
Not right now, or right now. She's all, dude, what the fuck?
Yes.
Cause I gotta go soon. If I'ma call you, I got two now, or I need to just go clean.
This decoy is not trying to waste her time with Babs. I mean, and Babs, so it goes back to them, just these predators wanting to get sexual gratification, not only from actually meeting up, but also from talking about meeting up. And the decoy is just not fucking down to allow him any of that. Call now.
Let me get the phone.
Okay.
Still okay to call?
Yes.
I am going to sign off.
Okay.
Talk to you in a sec.
Okay, and then so the decoy is going to explain what's going on here. Sadly, this chat happened before recording verification calls became routine, but thanks a lot to Legato Girl for assailing her ears long enough to speak to this creep. Yeah, so I don't know who Legato Girl is, but they really fucking took one for the team and talking to this fucking bastard for as long as she did. Okay, so based off of the times from the last message that he sent, which was at 2:04, and then the next message that he sends, which is at 2:16, and it's one that says, "You there?" which indicates, like, they've already talked on the phone, and now he's checking. So the phone call must have been just, like, you know, for a few minutes. It was just long enough to basically touch base and verify. It wasn't one of these fucking hour-long, like just bullshit sessions that a lot of these guys ask for. This decoy was not about to waste any time. The decoy probably kept it short and sweet, like intentionally. You there? Well, want you to know you sound great. You there? Damn, dude, it's only been 15 minutes. Chill out. Lol. I went back online and found what must be your neighbor. Lol, a little cutie like you. 13 though. Dude, that's not her neighbor. That's just another fucking perverted justice decoy luring predators like him who are on the internet looking for this shit and then exposing them to have nervous breakdowns for all of America to see.
Hey, I'm here. God, sorry, Mom. Mom's walked in on me.
No problem.
Nosy bitch.
Lol.
I liked your voice.
I liked yours too.
Smiley face. So what color of socks you want me to wear tomorrow?
What color is plaid skirt?
Like green and blue.
So white works. What other colors? Black and... Exactly, this is the schoolgirl thing that once again is exceptionally disturbing given that he was a fucking teacher.
Black socks. Black sort of works well. I got dark blue. White ones look the best.
Cool. Well, white works, so would the blue. Okay.
Smiley face. Okay, I gotta go and finish up with my cleaning, but I might BBL. I might be back later. Depends on if my mom's is gonna make me do a bunch of shit before she leaves.
Man, this is like reading a different language almost, just from all the fucking abbreviations and all the bullshit that she's typing.
Like, I'm her slave or something.
Okay. Want to be my slave instead? Wow, so that was a very subtle one. I didn't even pick up on that at first. It's like I'm her slave or something. Just like the way that the decoy said, okay, I'm gonna go pee. When she says it's like I'm her slave, she's opening the door to the kind of like BDSM, like dom and sub kind of dynamic, in the same way that she's almost hinting. She's not, of course, doing that explicitly, but I believe that these are intentional
they're intentional trails that the decoy is showing the predator to see if they're going to take a few steps further into the trail.
Okay. Want to be my slave instead?
But you're gonna come at 11 still, right? Lol, if you're nice to me, smiley face.
I will be. Maybe sometime when you can get away to shop, I will buy you sexy panties too.
Ooh, I would like that, but I have to hide them.
Yes.
Okay, so in case you're not back later, you'll be here at 11?
Address?
I can get on tomorrow and give it to you.
Lol, chickening out? Lol, I gave you my number.
I'm not chicken, but just please don't use it till tomorrow. I don't want to get in trouble, okay?
Yeah, and I don't think you'd have to worry about that. Babs would know that going to this house when he believes that the parent would still be there would be the fucking end of him and the end of his whole life. So I don't think that, I think that's a concern that would probably not materialize. Even though he eventually would do that, I believe Babs would be suspicious enough to only show up when the coast is clear. He was paranoid when he showed up, so he was already paranoid even when the decoy said that the mom had already left.
Of course.
Just like your number.
I don't either. Lol, I could go to jail. See, exactly. He's acknowledging he's a little dude. I don't want to fucking get locked up.
Can you get directions from that?
Yes.
I think they got sites online. You can look it up.
Yeah, this is back in the days of MapQuest. Fuck, and people weren't using Google Maps back then.
Okay. 11, right? So I can get up in the morn?
Yup.
Okay, cool.
Triple smiley faces.
I gotta go. This is stupid crap. So I'll talk to you later. If not, then tomorrow, okay?
Okay. Try to get on this afternoon, okay?
I will if Mom's gets off my ass in time.
Cool. Would love for you to call again.
I'll try to. But only when you say.
Okay.
Okay. Talk to you later for now. Kiss face.
Bye.
Hi, Beth. How are you on? What the fuck kind of question is that? Hi, Beth. How are you on? Oh, and then he hits her up again. Babs is a fucking needy person. Jeez. So he stops talking to her at 2:47. Sends another message at 5:34. And then just, hi, how are you on? And then another one at 6:57. At 7. Jeez. He is giving her a little bit of a barrage right here.
Hey, Beth, are you there? Hey, sexy, how are you?
Hey, sup?
Not much. Mom's still there.
Yeah, her plane's not leaving till like almost 9. Sucks.
Yeah. But you are alone in your room.
For right now, yeah.
Lol, okay.
Smiley face.
Can you call?
She's on the phone right now.
Okay.
What was that? I didn't hear nothing.
Listen, you are fairly close to me. I may have to make it earlier tomorrow.
Dude, he's trying to bullshit. He's talking about changing some plans, dude. You already agreed. The decoy's gonna call him out and be like, dude, a fucking deal's a deal, motherfucker.
Did you get the message?
Nah.
Did you get the message?
Nah. I gotta wake up that early. I gotta wake up that early? Come on.
Oh, so she's not even trying to wake up that early? Jeez. She's just saying that she's not even down to fucking wake up.
Well, I have to take son someplace early in the afternoon. Jeez. And he's just gonna talk about his fucking son like that.
I wonder how old the son was. Man, how could you type that and then be completely oblivious to the parallels between your own child and the child that you're talking to? That's so fucked up.
Well, I have to take son someplace early in the afternoon.
Like, how early?
How about 10? Do you know this girl?
Oh, and then this is the link to the other fucking decoy. The other one. Oh, loves math? Is that what it says? Is that the decoy? ASH loves math? I wonder if he would say that he's a fucking math teacher, like, just to try and score points with that decoy. That's, oh man, too bad we did not get to see that fucking chat log too.
Nah, why?
I think she goes to the same school as you.
Oh, then he sends another picture.
No, I don't know her. She might go to my school, though. I don't know too many people.
Dude, that's your fucking fellow, that's your fellow decoy. But of course, you'd have to say that you didn't know. That's kind of funny. It's like being a spy. Like, you're like, it's just rules for the game. You know, like, the deception is, like, a part of the fucking job. It's, like, it's required for the job.
I don't know her. She might go to my school, though. I don't know many people.
Yeah, I know. I am very excited about tomorrow.
Me too, but hey, I'm going to be up a little late tonight with my friend Bree. So can we do 11, please? I'm not going to be able to get up.
Bree? She's sleeping over? Wow, so this is the introduction of another character into this plot. Aside from the decoy that Babs is mentioning to the decoy that we're reading, there's someone else that the decoy is going to mention.
Yeah, I know. I'm very excited about tomorrow.
Me too, but hey, I'm going to be up a little late tonight with my friend Bree. So can we do 11, please?
So not only is the decoy introducing another character here with her friend Bree, she is emphasizing that, like, dude, there's so many people who are going to show up this thing. Like, I really need you to show up at this time. The machine is already in motion. You know, schedules have been set.
I'm not going to be able to get up.
Bree, she's sleeping over.
Well, she's sneaking out because her parents didn't want her to go out, but she's coming over.
Yeah, so I think this is definitely a move on the decoy's part to see what Babs is going to make of the information that she's presenting him. So she's letting him know, okay, there might be someone else who's going to be similar in age who also is going to be at the house. Is he going to suggest trying to do whatever? Is he going to try and be even more sinister than he is just talking to the decoy?
Okay.
So she's not sleeping over, but we're going to be up a little late.
That's okay.
What time?
That's okay. What time will she be leaving?
I don't know, like maybe 1 or 2.
Okay. Should really get it cleared with her mom so she could sleep over.
You could come over, like, late tonight if you want to.
I would love to.
It would have to be late, like 1 a.m. Can you do that?
No, lol, can't get out that late. Would love to come over though, lol.
Yeah, no shit, because he's just got the middle. It's probably just a fucking family night with Babs. Like, hey, what's he gonna tell his wife at 1 a.m? Like, hey, don't mind me. I just gotta go. I gotta go do some business real quick. I have to go return some videotapes real quick.
Aww.
If I did, would be about 9:30.
Too close to mom's. Leaving. I want to make sure she's on that plane, lol. I guess I can do 10. I'll just go to bed a little early.
I know, it's kind of ridiculous. The decoy is like saying that, like, literally 10 is too early, that she's not gonna be able to wake up. I mean, it's a good attempt, right? It's a good attempt, but I think that maybe they could have thought of something a little more effective.
You have fun with Bree, lol. If I could get out tonight, I would be there at 10.
Lol, okay. So you'll be here at 10? How long can you stay?
Tomorrow?
Yeah! I meant at 10 in the morning. Like you used before.
2 to 2/12 hours, I think, at least. What the fuck is 2-2/12?
That's a pointless and nonsensical arrangement of time for him to say. It doesn't make any sense.
Oh, that's cool then.
Yes, we can try different things. Mom's still on the phone?
Yeah, she's talking to the friends. She's gonna see. I said, damn, she's gonna go see. I said, damn, you about to go see him in a little bit. Damn, BRB.
Okay.
I'm back.
Cool. Who is she? Who is she going to see?
Just friends of hers she knows for a long time.
He or she. What the fuck? That's him getting paranoid. He's imagining like a potential stepdad in the situation. I think that's the point for him to ask that.
Two are married and there's like 2 other girls.
Oh, okay. Girls. Yeah, so that was Babs just feeling around to see if there was going to be a stepdad in the picture, because that would be a wet blanket on his plans.
Oh, okay. Girls. Girls weekend out.
Yeah, wish she would hurry up, lol.
Lol, me too.
Smiley face. Tomorrow is going to be so much fun.
Yes, it is. Are you going to tell Bree?
I don't know. I'm not sure if she would tell or not.
Yeah? That's not good. And good reason for me not to even try to get there tonight. Lol. Although if she were cool, that would be fun. Dude, of course he's gonna fucking respond to that. But the decoy just is not, for whatever reason, is not ready for him to come over tonight. Despite kind of just throwing this out to see what he's gonna say.
Okay, lol. Better make sure she doesn't come back over tomorrow morning.
She's not. She's got to be back for her parents, see? She's got to be back for her parents, see?
Yeah, but she knows your mom is gone and may want to come back over when she wakes up. See, he is kind of paranoid. He's just raising like, oh, well, like, what if this happens?
Nah, her parents won't let her come over when my mom's not there. That's why she's got to sneak out.
That's a good response to his fucking fear. That's a good way to kind of quell that.
Oh, okay.
Yep.
I am dripping pre-cum already. Jeez, this guy is extremely graphic. He's just making these quick little literotica entries with each fucking line.
What's that?
Oh my god, so we're about to get biology with Walter Babst.
When excited and erect, cock starts to ooze pre-cum. Clear liquid, slippery, helps me slide in better. But I can tell you, I am so excited by you. We will have to do it a few times. First time, I probably won't last very long at all.
That will be cool if it feels good, and I'll want to a couple times.
It will. May.
Hurt a little for the first time, but after that, it's awesome.
Why is it hurt the first time?
Hymen. Yeah, so that's very disturbing that he's actually going into the specifics, but yeah, so obviously he's spent a fair amount of time thinking about it. He must have a vivid imagination, and he's imagining all the things as he's typing them, you know. So this just goes to show that he spent a lot of time thinking about it, and when these guys spend a lot of time thinking about it, it normalizes it, and it oftentimes makes it easier for them to actually carry it out in real life. So, hymen.
What's that?
Lol, not sure myself, but it's in you.
Oh, so he doesn't even know what the fuck? You're the teacher, though, dude.
And I will probably bust, though. Some girls don't have one, or it tears naturally. It's natural. Lol. But that's what they mean by taking cherry or virginity.
And it's funny that the decoy in Perverted Justice on the entry, it says something about him like liking the band Cherry Pop and Daddies, which I guess like the band is trying to be edgy like by doing that. But I don't think that's necessarily indicative of him like flaunting being a predator. To my knowledge, it was just a band. I don't know. Maybe there's something going on there more, but who fucking knows?
Ew, sounds a little gross.
Yes, that is, lol, but it's special too, we'll be gentle. When I feel it, I will kiss you, and then push through.
Aw, thank you, I know you will make it nice.
I will try.
Mom's calling me because dinner just got here, so I gotta go.
Okay, look, look for me after dinner.
Kiss face.
Bye, kiss face.
And then here we go to the next day.
Hey, are you online? Were you just joking with me because I'm 12? I thought you were going to be on.
And then the next day.
Hey, my friend Bree wanted me to go do something with her, but I should be back later. If I'm not on in time, then just come on to the house.
And they must have carried out the rest in some kind of chat on the phone because that's the end of the chat log. So here we have it, the kinky man in Corona. Really, someone whose mind was completely warped and had probably been gradually becoming more and more warped after excessive amounts of just spending time online, looking at all this pornography, and as he says in his chat with Chris, talking about it, because he says that he talks about this shit online. So Babs just had such a vivid fantasy life, you know, it consumed him, and that's why he's a predator. That doesn't mean that he's not a predator. He is. Babst is one of the worst and more serious predators just because he was abusing his role as a teacher, and he seemed to take pride in that. So he's a diabolical and twisted human being. And it's good to know that even years later, you know, people can still track him down and we can still find pictures of him and we can still look up where he's at and still troll him to this day. So until next time, everyone.